Good morning children, welcome to class 5 social studies. So today we are going to start with a new lesson, Saudi Arabia children. Okay, a country in the hot desert region. So already we have seen the major landforms itself, what would be the desert like. So here this country of Saudi Arabia is located in a hot desert region children. So you would have been having some idea what would be a desert look like. Okay, so how the country is present, where it is located, what is its vegetation, what is its wildlife, how, what are the cities, what will be the people's occupation, like that on topics we are going to see children. First we will see what is a desert. A desert is a barren land children, barren and a dry area. Okay, because why? Because it doesn't sometimes there is little rainfall or there will be no rainfall only. Okay, for over many years some of the desert region have not received rain children. Okay, so desert is a barren and a dry area which receives little or no rainfall children. Okay, there are two types of deserts children. One is hot desert and another one is cold desert. Okay, the hot desert, so Saudi Arabia is a hot desert region. The cold desert is your Ladakh children. Okay, in India, in Jammu and Kashmir you have Ladakh, that is a cold desert. Okay, so where these hot deserts are located we will see children. The hot deserts are located near the Tropic of Cancer. Okay, the most hot deserts are located near Tropic of Cancer, and in the southern hemisphere it is near Tropic of Capricorn. Okay, it is in the southern hemisphere, it is near Tropic of Capricorn. And mainly what we observe now children, the deserts are located on the western parts of the continent. Okay, mainly the deserts are located on the western parts of the continent. So here the Saudi Arabia is the largest country which doesn't have a river children to flow through. Okay, Saudi Arabia is the largest country which doesn't have a river through flow through. So observe this map children. Okay, so here which is given in peach color, no, they are all deserts children. Okay, see, observe that this is east, west, north, south. See, more deserts are located in the Tropic of Cancer children. Okay, more deserts are located in the Tropic of Cancer, and in the southern hemisphere it is near the Tropic of Capricorn. Okay, so so many deserts are being located, just we will observe there in the map children. So starting from the right hand side, in Australia you have the Great Australian Desert. Okay, the Great Australian Desert. In Africa you have the Namib, okay, desert, and one more is Kalahari. Okay, Namib and Kalahari desert children. Then in South America you have the Patagonian desert, and near the Peru you have the Atacama desert children. Okay, before this also you would have learnt about Atacama desert. It is one of the driest region children, Atacama desert. And again starting in the North America you have the North American desert children. Then coming to Africa you have one more, the world largest desert children, Sahara. Okay, the world largest desert, Sahara. And then you have the Arabian. So this place only your country Saudi Arabia is located. Okay, then next you have the Iranian desert. Then in India you have the Thar desert. Okay, in Russia you have the Turkestan desert, and then and one more place you have the desert children, that is Takia Makan Gobi desert. Okay, it covers Russia and China children, Takia Makan and Gobi desert. Okay, so Sahara is the largest desert children. So from the word desert itself they have formed D for dry, E for empty, S for sandy, E for extreme climate, R for reptiles or ripples, and T for treeless. So these are the features we observe in the desert children. Okay, then moving on to the next one, where Saudi Arabia is located. Okay, that one location we will see, Saudi Arabia. So this is your country, Saudi Arabia, children. So the Arabian Desert. This is your Arabian Desert lies to the southwest of Arabian Peninsula. So you have the Arabian Peninsula here, children. To the southwest of it, you have Saudi Arabia. Okay, the almost whole country occupies the Arabian Desert. Then it is the Middle East country and the fifth largest country in Asia. Okay, so fifth largest country in Asia. Then it has following countries surrounding around it. So the what are the countries we will see now? Okay, in the north you have Jordan, Iraq and Kuwait. Okay, you have Jordan, Iraq and Kuwait. Then in the eastern side you have Qatar, Bahrain, UAE lie to the east, children. Okay, Qatar, Bahrain and UAE lie to the east, and Oman and Yemen lie to the west. Okay, this side, children. Oman and Yemen lie to the west, and the Red Sea is to the west. Okay, Red Sea is to the west, and Persian Gulf is to the east of the country. This side you have the Persian Gulf, children. Okay, so when you study the location, take the map and read along with it, then only you should know. So north, south, east, west, like that location you should know and read it, children. Then it will be easily you can remember. Okay, the next one, relief features. The relief features, so as it is a desert region, it mainly consists of rocky plateaus, children. Okay, rocky plateau covered by a vast desert. There are mountains, so you can observe some green color patch over here, children, to the west, to the Red Sea. You can observe some green color this thing. These are mountains, children, to the west of Saudi Arabia. Okay, then in the south you have the desert, children. Okay, Rub al Khali. Okay, Rub al Khali, that is the desert. And in the northern part you have the An-Nafud. Okay, An-Nafud, these are the two desert present in the north and the southern regions, children. Okay, observe in the west, as there are mountains, there are steep mountains along the coast of Red Sea, along the west coast. Okay, there you have highest point, children, that is your Jabal Sawda. You can observe here in your map, Jabal Sawda. Okay, this is the highest point in Saudi Arabia. And then the slopes, no, children. So mountain is there, means after that you will get slopes, no. So the slopes are gently going down in the northeast, children. And then as usual, you know, as it is a desert region, so the sand will be blown by the wind. You will have dunes formed by the deposition of sand, children. Okay, when the wind blows, the sand gets fly off and go and settle in one place. Okay, so that forms a dunes over there by the deposition of strong winds, children. And the climate is, as you shall know, yes, it is a desert region. It's going to be very hot. In the summer, it is extremely hot, but the nights are relatively cool. So summer season is from May to September. Okay, then during the winter season, it is from October to April. The days are warm, but the nights are very cold, children. So as we have learned to know, in the desert region, during daytime the sand gets heated up fast. Okay, in the night time also the sand loses the heat fast only. So it becomes very cool, that land, children. So the temperatures are mild in the coastal regions, children. Sometimes sand storms, as I told you, how we have in the rain cup cyclones are there, like that in the desert region you have the sand storms, children. So the sand along with the wind will blow at a higher speed, children. Okay, so when it is occasionally when it is rainfall, you have wide gullies or streams called wadis are formed, children. Okay, wide gullies or streams called wadis are formed. Here also in soil you can observe that
okay, flat land will be there. When it rains means what? A small stream, like the soil will get eroded and you will have a small pit over there like this. Okay, the water will be flowing in there. Okay, and then the hill stations are Al Thaif and Aba. Okay, the hill stations are Al Thaif and Aba in the western coastal region. It remains cool throughout the summer, children. There is a main thing, as it gets very less rainfall, there is shortage of water in the desert region, Saudi Arabia, children. So take their textbook and read it, children. Okay, then see you in the next class. Thank you.